My name is Phloeun Prim. I'm the executive director of Cambodian Living Arts. It's a non-for-profit based here in Phnom Penh, Cambodia. It's a great honor for me to be part of this series launched by my friend Danny Tan at the Odyssey Dance Theater. So today I want to share with you about the work of Cambodian Living Arts, how in this time of change in our humanity, how our organization here in Cambodia have faced the pandemic. And also I'd love to share also future aspirations of our work and how we are looking forward. So maybe to begin the story about Cambodian Living Arts, we just celebrated our 20th anniversary of work in Cambodia. So for the past 20 years, Cambodian Living Arts had been instrumental to support the revival of traditional performing arts in Cambodia, but also investing in the young generation of Cambodian artists. Our story began in the late 90s by our founder, Arn Chon Pon, who is a Cambodian survivor of the genocide. And I think the power of the story of Arn is music saved his life. In fact, you can listen to a TEDx talk about the story of how he survived the Khmer Rouge and the genocide through learning the music. So Arn's vision was to come back to Cambodia and help restoring the arts of Cambodia, where there is an estimate of about 80% of the artists among the 2 million people who were killed during the Cambodia genocide. So because of that devastation and somehow the unrooting of Cambodian culture, it was clear and essential that 20 years ago we wanted to make sure that we are preserving and helping to revive many of these art forms. So we begin by finding masters in their country, in the countryside, and focusing on art form that was about to disappear. And our mission at that time was simply to give back dignity to these masters in order for them to teach the next generation of artists and young people. So the first decade of our work really began by the focus on the transmissions of these oral traditions. And I would say probably how we speak about the last decade of our work is really focusing on the generation of youth, of young people that makes the fabric of Cambodia today. Because after the work that we've done on restoring culture and inspiring young people to create work, the idea was to find a way for them to sustain, for them to express, and for them also to create. So today, Cambodian Living Arts work and focus are on few areas. The first one is arts education. So we work in partnership with the Ministry of Education of Cambodia to support, in fact, the reform of education of Cambodia and bring arts education to public schools of Cambodia. We have a second program that we nurtured for the past 20 years that have grown up significantly, which is really to support artists. We call it the Arts Development Project Program, and the focus is supporting artists through commission work, to creating festivals, to giving grant scholarship to students to pursue studies in the arts. So this has been really core of CLA's mission, and we are continuing to do that. Our third program is what we call the Knowledge Network and Policy. It's somehow we could say it's our advocacy arms. It's working with researchers, advocating for culture with the government and different stakeholders. And one of the main program around this, project around it, is also leadership. Is after 20 years of work in Cambodia over the past 5-6 years. In fact, our focus have shifted to from the master to students, but now I would say it's probably the next generation of master is those cultural leader that we want to keep nurturing, bringing them tools, connecting them with people in Cambodia, but also regionally and globally. So we run also a really important leadership program to support the sector in Cambodia. So I think this makes off today what I think Cambodian Living Arts is focusing. We also have expanded our project with regional outreach. So we've launched a sister organization called the Mekong Cultural Hub in 2017. And the Mekong Cultural Hub is focusing on cultural exchange of knowledge, creative resource, and artist exchange within the region. So I think, you know, in this time of the pandemic and COVID-19, I think many of us have reset the way we think about our work and the way we think about the world, the way we think about our humanity. But I think what's really clear is how important I think the work in arts and culture still is relevant, even, and I would say probably even more relevant in this time of crisis. Through the experience of Cambodian Living Arts as a post-conflict society, you know, where we went through a genocide, I think the time that we're living is also a conflict. It's a different conflict. I've heard people saying like it's a war with an invisible enemy. But I think it's important that we see and we keep ourselves creative, so that we can imagine a future together that we will be living in. So I think the investment that we are doing right now in the arts with cultural leader, with also continuing to commission work for artists, you know, is so important because it keeps us alive, and I think it gives us a sense of how we can imagine our humanity post this pandemic and the COVID-19. On our side, as an organization, we hit it hard also. I think because we also have a performing arts arms where we set up a platform to do performances for the tourist market. So back last March, the government asked all institutions, artistic cultural institutions, to stop doing any live performances. So we had to stop our program. Because we were focusing on the tourist market, I would say probably now there's almost no one is coming into the country as tourists. So the tourist sector had been hardly hit. We had to restructure our organizations because 40% of our income were coming from those earned income, tourists buying our tickets, experiencing our dance, music, and I think, you know, it was really difficult to also stop working with the artists and staff that we did love each other for many, many years to build the program. But I think we took a hard decision in early time in order to save and to keep the institution strong through this pandemic. And I think this is where, as an organization, it allows us today to continue to do our work, to invest in the future, and to believe in the future. So next month, as everything reopening, we are going to launch a cultural season that is also targeted Cambodian youth, and that will be speaking on the thematic of identity, them and us, and us and them. And I think this is really inspirational because I think the work of the artists that we commission, they all work during this pandemic time. So the thought, the way they have created was in this time of crisis. So I'm really looking to see the work that will be coming out from these Cambodian artists. And I think, you know, my message to you all who are listening is, I think, you know, arts and culture has always existed. It's part of our life and will exist because it makes us live and it makes us create and believe in our future. So thank you very much for being part of this program, and please don't hesitate to look in our website, CambodianLivingArts.org. Thank you to ODT Dance Theatre for inviting me to speak. Thank you.